Dear friends, today we will discuss the twaik. Twaik mean three. Twaik mean three terminal device, three terminal semiconductor device, and which can be operated on both the polarities of AC. That's the name twaik. Twaik mean three. AC mean the dual polarity in the both direction the twaik can be operated. Okay, and before discussing the twaik, because SCR is very closely related to the twaik, so first of all we'll go through the a brief review about the what is the SCR. So SCR, you know, silicon controlled rectifier, it is a unidirectional. Okay, like here there are the four layers of SCR, PN. This one is the anode, this one is the cathode, and this terminal is called the gate. Okay, and you know, it is unidirectional. As the current flows from anode to the cathode, when anode is at positive potential and cathode is at negative potential. Now we are coming to the twaik. You know, twaik mean three terminal, and AC mean it is operated in both directions. Okay. So, in a sinusoidal AC switching circuits, the unidirectional switching may be a problem, like a thyristor or SCR. So, twaik is basically similar to the thyristor, but twaik is bidirectional. Similar to thyristor, you look, there is one thyristor, there is second thyristor, and they are connected together. They are connected together like this. They are connected together like this. So one thyristor, second thyristors, and gate terminals are connected together also. So this is our one connection, and here they are connected together, and that becomes the second connection. Now the symbol is like this. Okay, this is one SCR, anode, cathode, and the gate terminal. Second SCR, anode, cathode. So two SCR, they are in anti-parallel direction, and they are connected together, and their gates are joined together. That becomes the twaik, and the exact symbol, true symbol of the twaik is this one. Okay, of course obtained from this circuit. Now, you know how the working, first of all we'll understand the working of the SCR. You know, SCR is a four layer device. Why we are studying SCR? Because twaik is made up of two SCRs. Okay, so that's why we are going to SCR first of all. The four layer device PN. Okay, this is you know, anode, this is cathode. From PNN there is a junction J1, from NP there is a second junction J2, PN there is another junction J3. Okay, and a potential is applied here through a resistance. A potential is of 10 volt, suppose. Okay, then plus 5 potential will be here. Plus 5. Then plus 3, plus 2, plus 1, 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 5 will be at here. Plus 5 to minus 5, you know, the difference is 10 volts. So just look, J1, this B is at plus 5 as compared to N, which is 3. So J1 is forward biased. This N is at minus 5 with respect to P, which is minus 3. So N is more negative as compared to P. So J3 is forward biased. But here N is 3, P is minus 3. Reverse. So J2 is reverse biased. Okay. So this potential, when it is applied, J1 and J2 are, J1 and J3 are forward biased, J2 is center, J2 is reverse biased. So a very little current flow on applying the potential, and if it is a variable, you know, if it is a variable, what happened? You go on varying this potential difference and note down the current flowing, and keep in mind that there is no voltage at the gate, and very little current will flow. You go on increasing this. Ultimately, what happens at a certain voltage, the junction J2 breaks down. When J2 breaks down, what happens? Suddenly, a very heavy current starts flowing, and you know, like this curve, this is going like this, very small current, leakage current. Here the breakdown takes place, breakdown happens, there's a breakover voltage, and suddenly, you know, the potential falls down, potential across the SCR falls down, and heavy current starts flowing like this. So this is called SCR. It is in the on state. Now it is in on. Before breakover voltage here, it was in the off state, and without any, you know, the gate voltage. There's a function of the gate voltage. Like if you giving some voltage to the gate positive, okay, if you give some and here current, you know, positive current here to the gate, what happened? Then, you know, breakover voltage decreases and breakdown happens at somewhat low voltage. Breakdown happens at this voltage with the gate. You know, when, because this is P layer, when some positive current, you know, positive potential is applied to the gate, then at some low potential the breakdown happens. Okay, so this is working of the SCR. Now it is the same, like if there is no gate potential, okay, this is the curve, right? If you are giving some gate voltage, then breakdown happens at this one. Okay, so this is all about the working of SCR, right? So this is a voltage, you know, from here to here when the SCR it is on. When it is off, you know, much higher voltage, you know, it occurs across the SCR. But when it is on, a very small voltage. Okay. Something to be noted that while increasing the gate current, you know, no gate current, then small gate current, then high gate current, in a same way, the breakover voltage decreases, you know, as the gate current becomes higher and higher, you know, breakover voltage decreases exactly in the same way, right?
So now let that
this is our SCR, okay, and SCR can be supposed to made up of two transistors, right? Like this is PNP, PNP, okay, from here to here. Then you know second transistor is this one, NPN. So this is NPN. So this one PNP, emitter base collector. NPN again, emitter base collector. So actually this base and collector there, it is one layer, okay. So base of this transistor is connected with the base of T1 transistor is connected with the collector of T2. Similarly, here the collector of T1 mean this, because this is a common layer, this is a common layer. Now here collector of T1 is connected to the base of T2. This emitter is separate, this emitter is separate. So there are two transistors, this one and this one. This is PNP, this is NPN. So this is P, arrow downwards, PNP, this is NPN. And collector of T1 is connected to base of T2, and collector of T2 is connected to base of T1. So they are interconnected, and this is the gate, okay, and this one is anode, this one is cathode. Now here notice that there are two thyristors. This is a trike, this one is trike, this one is trike. And here in case of the trike, this is one SCR, the second SCR, they are connected here, and gate is here. Now let's coming to the first quadrant. First quadrant mean like this one is positive comes here, negative comes here. Then first quadrant, if negative comes here and positive comes here, then third quadrant. So let's coming to the first quadrant. Positive is here and negative is here. Now there are two options for the, two options about the, about the gate. If the gate is given a positive, if the gate is like this one, mod, this mod. Okay, this mod gate is positive. So what happened? Gate current is given, and depending upon the gate current, breakdown happens at the low voltage, at here, at this voltage, and then current shoots, right? And second triggering can be done by giving a negative pulse to the gate. But this is not a sensitive case. This is, triggering will happen for this gate current, but at higher gate current it triggers. If we give positive pulse here, then triggering takes place at the lower gate current, a low value of the gate current, the triggering takes place. But if you opt this choice by giving a negative pulse to the P, then breakdown will happen, but somewhat higher gate current will be needed for it. So this is the difference between the two. So that means this mod is more sensitive as compared to this mod. Now coming to the third quadrant. Third quadrant means we are giving negative here and positive here. Then this SCR will conduct. Okay. And again, if we give a negative pulse, negative gate current, negative current to the gate, so then breakdown happens at lower voltage, and then current shoots. you can give a positive pulse to the gate, but then if you are giving positive pulse to gate, then more gate current will be needed. So this is the difference. So negative mean like this mode 3, this is more sensitive as compared to 3 plus mode. If we are giving positive pulse here, it will trigger, but somewhat more gate current is needed. Okay, so this is the explanation of TWIC. Now there are some applications of the TWIC. You can go through. They're very simple, right?